Hello friends, welcome to my channel eGrammar. Now, in this video, we are going to see change the voice in present perfect tense. Now, what I have done here, I divided this tense into three forms like affirmative sentences, then negative sentences and questions. Now, we are going to see how to convert this type of sentence and questions into change the voice, means from active voice to passive voice. Take a look at the sentence how we write in active voice of present perfect tense. Subject, then have, has, then third form of the verb and then object. Now it depends, this have, has, this is the form of be. Okay, now it depends on the subject, which word means this, which form of the be we are going to use in active voice. Now while converting this type of sentence into passive voice, there are certain changes, means subject goes at the place of object and object comes at the place of subject. Okay, object comes first, then the form of be. Among these two, it depends what type of our object is. If the object is singular, at the time we use has. If the object is plural, at the time we are going to use have. And exactly after this word, means after this form of be, we have to use this word been in present perfect tense in passive voice. After been, this word means this third form of the verb, it is also known as past participle form. Okay, so after been, the third form of the verb, and exactly you have to stick this word by to the third form of the verb, and then comes subject. Now there are certain changes happens with the subject. Not all the subject changes, but there are certain subjects who changes. See what happened when converting sentence from active to passive. What happened with the subject? I becomes me, we become us, they becomes them, you remain as you, he become him, she become her, it remain it, name remain name. Now this red colored word, you can easily see them, they do not change while converting sentence from active to passive. But these remaining subjects, he, I, we, they, he, she, they changes from active to passive. Understood? Now take a look at the formula in present perfect tense for affirmative sentences. Let me write the sentence first. He has written a letter. Now this is our sentence in present perfect tense. While converting this active voice sentence into passive voice, the object comes at the place of subject. So our sentence would be sound like this. A letter has been written by him. Now let us apply our formula on this. Subject, has or have, then the third form of the verb and then object. Now object comes at the place of subject. Now take a look at our object. What type of our object is? See, our object is singular. So we are going to use has. So a letter has, exactly after has we have to use this word been. A letter has been, this been word. After that we have to use the third form of the verb, written. Written, we should stick this by word to this written. Then written by, he becomes him. So a letter has been written by him. Now take a look at another example where our object is plural. See, they have written letters. In passive voice, letters have. Why we are going to use here have? Because our object is plural. Okay? So letters have been written by them. Understood? Now, let's see some example for this. I have eaten an apple. An apple has been eaten by me. You have played football. Football has been played by you. We have sung songs. Songs have been sung by us. He has drunk milk. Milk has been drunk by him. She has written letters. Letters have been written by her. Sam has sold vegetables. Vegetables have been sold by Sam. Understood? Now, let's move to the negative sentence in present perfect tense. Let's see the sentence first. He has not written a letter. Now we are going to make negative sentence, that was I have used here not. He has not written a letter. In passive voice, a letter has not been written by him. Now let us apply our formula on this. See, subject, have or has, it depends on the subject what we are going to use, have or has. Then comes not, this not word, because we are going to make sentence in negative. Okay. Then the third form of the verb, it is past participle form, you can say that. So object, after that object. Now in passive voice, object comes at the place of subject and subject goes at the place of object. So object. Now our object, see, our object is singular. It works as subject here in passive voice, but our object is singular. So a letter, this is singular, that's why I'm going to use has. A letter has. After this form of be, we have to use this not word. This is compulsory. Then a letter has not. After not, because we are converting negative sentence into passive voice. So after has, we have to use this not word, and then been. Been, this is compulsory. So a letter has not been written. Third form of the verb, and that after third form of the verb, we have to stick this word by, compulsory word, to the verb. And then comes subject. Now subject changes, he becomes him. So a letter has not been written by him. Now take a look at the example where our object is plural. They have not written letters. In passive voice, letters have. Why have? Because our object is plural form. In plural form. So letters have not been written by them. Understood? Now take a look at some example for this. I have not eaten an apple. An apple has not been eaten by me. You have not played football. Football has not been played by you. We have not sung songs. Songs have not been sung by us. He has not drunk milk. Milk has not been drunk by him. She has not written letters. Letters have not been written by her. Sam has not sold vegetables. Vegetables have not been sold by Sam. Understood? Now, let us move to the last part, that is question in present perfect tense. Let's see. First question, has he written a letter? In passive voice, has a letter been written by him? Now let us apply our formula on this. See, our question start in present perfect tense with have or has. It depends on the subject. Then the third form of the verb and then object. In this manner, we write our question in present perfect tense. Now we are converting this question into passive voice. So, I have already told you, subject and object, they change their places to each other. Now, don't think about this form of bees, have and has. First think about object. Okay, our object comes first in passive voice. So what type of our object is? Is it singular or plural? Yes, our object is singular. So we have to use has. What if our object is plural? At the time we have to use this have. Okay, but now we know that our object is singular. So we are going to use this word has, means this form of be has. So question starts with has. Has a letter. Now in this part, after this object, we have to use, means this object is working as a subject here, but we will say it an object. Okay, so after this object, we have to use this word been. Okay, this is compulsory. So has a letter been written by him? And then question mark. What if our object is plural? Now take a look at this example also. Has he written letters? In passive voice, have letters. Why we are going to use have here? Because our object is plural. So have letters been written by him? And then question marks. Understood? See, some example for this. Have I eaten an apple? Has an apple been eaten by me? Have you played football? Has football been played by you? Have we sung songs? Have songs been sung by us? Has he drunk milk? Has milk been drunk by him? Has she written letters? Have letters been written by her? Had Sam sold vegetables? Have vegetables been sold by Sam? Now, if you look at these three forms of sentence, affirmative sentence, then negative sentence, then questions, you might have observed this. This been, third form of the verb and by and then subject. This form, these four words remain as it is. They do not change, neither in affirmative sentence, neither in questions, neither in negative sentence. They remain as it is. This first part in passive voice, they changes. It changes. Understood? I hope you might have understand this, what I have told you. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe and like the video. Thank you very much.